In this video, I'll show you how to crop photos using the Photoshop Crop tool and explain some of its many features. You'll find the Crop tool in the Photoshop Tools palette on the left of the interface. When you select it, you can see its options displayed in the context-sensitive toolbar at the top of the interface. The first choice you need to make is to decide if you want to crop the image to a ratio or a size. To explain the difference, let's select the 16:9 crop ratio from the drop-down list. The grid overlay then appears on the image, indicating the crop area. I can then apply this by clicking the tick mark in the Photoshop toolbar. Now let's check the image size by selecting the image menu and then the image size option. This tells us that the image is 5,184 pixels wide. This is the same width as the original image. All that's changed is the image height, which was reduced when I cropped the image. I'll undo that now by pressing Command and Z on my keyboard to show you the other option. If you're using a Windows PC, that's Control and Z. This time, I won't select the ratio in the drop-down. Instead, I'll choose an image size using the Width and Height option. Now we see three boxes where we can enter the image width, height, and resolution. Let's enter the image size of 1920 by 1080 pixels, but I won't enter a new resolution. That will leave the image at its existing resolution when I make the crop. As I enter the height and width values, we see the crop overlay we saw earlier. The overlay looks the same as before because the dimensions I've entered are still in the ratio of 16:9. I can then apply my crop by clicking the tick mark again. Notice this time that the image is reduced in size. It now measures only 1920 pixels wide rather than the 5,184 pixels it measured before. I'll undo that now by using the Edit menu and clicking the Undo option. I can also use the shortcut again of Command and Z on a Mac or Control and Z on a Windows PC. Let's leave the crop size set to 1920 by 1080 pixels, but this time I'll click on the image and drag using my mouse. As I do this, the crop area appears as a dotted outline. Then when I release my mouse button, we see the crop overlay again. If I don't select the correct area, I can click and drag the image using my mouse. This repositions the image inside the crop area. If you don't like repositioning the image and would prefer to move the crop area, press P on your keyboard. You're then able to move the crop rather than the image. Press P again and you return to repositioning the image. Also, if you haven't made the crop quite the right size, you can click and drag the handles on the corners and along the edges. This resizes the crop area, but notice it keeps the image's aspect ratio so that each side is resized in proportion. For example, if I click and drag the top left corner, the bottom right corner stays in the same location. But we can also change this behavior by holding down the Option key on our keyboard. On a Windows PC, that's the Alt key. This time when we resize the image, it's resized from the center. When you think you have the crop in the correct position, check by hiding the unwanted area of the image. You can do this by pressing H on your keyboard. Pressing H a second time then makes the image visible again. Finally, I can click the tick mark in the toolbar to apply the crop or press Enter on my keyboard. The crop tool in Photoshop also comes with several predefined presets. When we select one of these, it sets the width and height option in the toolbar, and there's also one of these for the ratio. We can also create new crop presets by selecting the new preset option in the drop-down list. This displays the dialog where I can enter the name of the new preset. Photoshop pre-populates this with the dimensions that I entered in the toolbar. When I'm happy with the name of the preset, I can click the OK button. The preset then appears in the drop-down list in the toolbar. Let's undo the crop we applied to this image so I can show you a few more features. First, I can clear the crop tool settings by clicking the clear button in the toolbar. Now let's select the preset that we've just created. Notice this two arrow icon between the fields. When I click this icon, it switches the values in the fields so we have a vertical crop. When I click it again, it switches them back. The crop tool also has a handy straighten tool, which you can use to level the image. I can activate this by clicking the level icon in the toolbar. I can then click on the horizon in my image and drag whilst holding down the mouse button. This allows me to draw a line along the horizon, and when I release the mouse button, Photoshop rotates the image to ensure the horizon's level. It's also possible to rotate the image manually by positioning your mouse pointer outside the crop area. Then you can click and drag to rotate the image around its center point. Whilst we've been cropping our image, we've been using a rule of thirds overlay. This divides the image into three sections vertically and horizontally. It's a common compositional technique photographers use, but we aren't restricted to just this overlay. There are others that we can use, which you'll find in the drop-down list in the toolbar. You can also cycle through the overlays by pressing the letter O on your keyboard. But perhaps you don't like seeing the overlay at all, in which case you can hide it using the drop-down. I have mine set to always be shown, but hiding it means it's never shown. A halfway house is to show it automatically. This means it's only visible when you click and drag to resize or reposition it on the image. You might also notice in the toolbar that we have an option to delete the cropped pixels. When we use this, it means that any pixels we crop are permanently deleted from the image. But if we don't tick it, and then we click on the image again using the crop tool, this displays the crop overlay, and you can see the original image outside of the crop area. This allows me to resize the crop to recover some of the hidden image. You can even crop outside of the area of the image. When I make the crop overlay larger than the image, that area becomes transparent, which is what this pattern means. What appears in this area is controlled by the drop-down to the right of the toolbar. The transparent option is selected by default, but we can also switch to the generative expand option. This uses Photoshop's new AI generative capability, but I'll save that for another video. The other option is the content aware fill. When I select that and resize the crop area outside the image, Photoshop generates new content to fill the empty area. The content aware feature is excellent and it's available in other places in Photoshop. Watch this video next and I'll show you yet another way to use it. Thanks for watching today and I hope you've enjoyed the video. Remember to subscribe if you haven't already and please share this with other Photoshop users. I'll see you soon for another video.